Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. So you will somewhat agree to me that in some ways programming is like riding a bike. You're not going to forget how to write code if you don't do it for a while. On the other hand, it's a skill that takes plenty of practice to learn and even more to maintain. So that's why I have compiled a list of coding apps to help you stay on top of your game by coding wherever you are. Before proceeding, please subscribe and hit that bell icon to stay updated with my upcoming videos. So the very first we will talk about is Inkai. Inkai is free to use. You can almost think of Inkai the same way you would an exercise app. It provides you with daily workouts, but here you are leveling up your coding skills instead of burning fat and building muscles. So simply select your language of choice and the app will keep you on track. The app supports everyone from beginners to more experienced coders. If you are just starting off, you can use the app to learn web technologies before moving on to the JavaScript. It doesn't teach you how to program either. Inkai also helps you to learn subjects related to programming, like using the Linux command line and managing version control with Git. Second one is Grasshopper. Unlike some of the other coding apps on this list, which features multiple languages, Grasshopper sticks to one, JavaScript. This makes sense as not only is JavaScript relatively easy to learn, but it's also used for a wide range of applications. To ensure you stick with it, Grasshopper motivates you to log in every day. And while it won't motivate everyone, it could be just what you need to keep you going. At least for now, this app is entirely free with no in-app purchases. Third one we'll talk about is SoloLearn, one of the best learn-to-code app on this list. Solo app earns major points for the sheer amount of learning material. Most of the other multi-language coding apps listed offer a few languages at best. SoloLearn, on the other hand, impressive language support including C, C++, Java, JavaScript, PHP, Python, Ruby, Swift, and many more. Like some of the other apps on this list, SoloLearn uses gamification to encourage you to stick with it. You will earn a skill points and achievements while you level up your progress no matter how you learn. If you are more competitive, you can compete with other learners around the world for more intense challenge. Fourth one is Code Academy Go. This is an essentially useful app if you are already Code Academy user. This app takes the courses and challenges from the website and presents them in app form. It's very much a does what it say on the tin sort of app, but that's not a bad thing. And also this app is entirely free. Fifth one is Hopscotch. Judging by the marketing surrounds the app, you might think Hopscotch is meant just for kids. Its name in the iOS App Store is even Hopscotch : Coding for Kids. While it's certainly kid friendly, don't let that chase you away. This is way more than an app for children. Looking at the FAQ on the Hopscotch website, the app is suitable for all ages. Developers say that while it's designed for people aged 7 to 13 and 18 years old, and even college students are learning with it as well. While other app focuses on fundamental first, Hopscotch aim to have you hit on the ground running. The goal is to have you creating apps or games within minutes. This can teach you the basic concepts of coding before you head for the deep end. Unfortunately, the app is limited for the time being as right now it's iOS only. Last but not the least, Encode. Encode offers JavaScript, Python, HTML and CSS, making it a good choice if you're looking to learn coding for web development. Whether you're using an Android or iOS, Encode makes coding easier by including a shortcut bar with symbols often used in coding. This saves you from having to search through your keyboard searching from different bracket symbols. This app is a few years old and while it is not as popular as some other, it's definitely worth a look. And yeah, that's all about my favorite list, and let me know in the comment section if you have already used any of them or any other app which is your favorite. And if you found this video helpful, please like this video and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.